All right, you guys, there's a Prolovia in the area. There he is. I see him. Gimme. I want him. I picked up an ant? Really? I didn't even think you could even pick up ants. Where the hell did that Prolovia go? What's up, guys? It's Rantium here, and today we are back in Ark Survival Evolved. That's right, you guys, we are back, and oh snap, is it gonna be an awesome freaking day? But first, if you guys enjoy what you're about to see, make sure you smash that like button, subscribe for more daily videos, and if you haven't done already, follow me on Twitter at CouchPotato1898. Link is down there in the description. So, last episode, guys, we did a crap ton of stuff over in the ice caves over on the right side of the map. I already got the artifact from that ice cave in there, but we spent most of the day inside of that ice cave over there. In fact, that one ice cave is basically where I almost met my end due to frostbite, but we made it out, guys, and the two T-Rexes are good to go. They're over there, and they're good to go. So anyways, guys, we have a name to give out because we got a Sabertooth two episodes ago, but it didn't have a name. So I have to thank Jupes with a Z 23. I love that. I like that name for Ginger. I love the name Ginger because she's got kind of like that reddish orange mane. And I mean, it fits it well, you know, it fits it pretty well. She's got that reddish orange mane and I like it. I like it so much. So anyways, guys, Ginger is our brand new Sabertooth. Oh, look at Insomnia. He's looking at me like I want to ride too. I'll ride you, Insomnia. Let's go out and get you some levels or something like that. I've already pumped melee damage into our Megalosaurus, but we've never actually ridden our Megalosaurus, like, at all. So let's just go out and just for shits and giggles and see what this bad boy can do. So let's see. What are we going to do today, guys? Well, today I've got a plan to go over into the Redwood biome and find a Prolovia. Now, we found a Prolovia back a couple, it was like probably 5 episodes ago, I believe, but we couldn't tame it because the RGs apparently can't pick up Prolovias, which is kind of interesting to me. If an RG can pick up a Baryonyx, an RG should be able to pick up a Prolovia, but then again, that's just my opinion. So, I want to try and get ourselves a Prolovia, and the only reason being is because I just want to have one, you know? I want to have one, just to see what it would be like, you know? Oh my god, I do 825 melee? Oh my god! I didn't know I did that much damage. Holy Jesus, criminy. So, the Prolovia itself is not the best dinosaur, it's not the best mammal in the game, that's for damn sure. But it is still super cool, the fact that it can just kind of bury underground and burrow itself into a little rock, or into the ground and make himself look like a rock. It's pretty much the best way to, like, booby trap your base and just have a whole bunch of cool stuff like that. Look at us, we're on top of a rock. Look at how awesome we look. But anyways, that's what I want to do. God, that freaking Tappy is so pink. Look at him. Level 20. God, that's like a straight pink Tappy. I have never seen a Tapijara that has been straight, like, one color. Look at that. I would almost tame that just to get the colors. Holy crap, that's cool. Hello, Therizinosaurus. Is one of you a female? Oh! Oh, God. Freaking... Okay, I'm flustered. Sideline everything I just said about getting a Prolovia at the beginning of the episode. We gotta tame that 145. Get out of the way, Fiomia. I'm taking you with me. You're gonna be my slave. So, oh my God, we have got to freaking get that freaking female Therizinosaurus. Oh my flipping God. That's going to be our mate boost, and we're going to be able to breed Therizinosauruses, guys. Oh my god. Okay, we got to go back and get some Trank Darts. Actually, no, let's do this smart. We have a Taming Pen now, and a Quetzal. Let's go grab the Quetzal, pick up the Therizinosaurus, drop her off inside of the Taming Pen, and then we'll be good to go. That way she can't get out, that way she can't break my damn armor, that way she doesn't run away. We've still got all the shocking tranquilizer darts. Why am I still carrying this Fiomia? I don't need no damn Fiomia, I've already got a Fiomia. Let's drop him off the cliff. I love the fact that this guy can do this. Boop! Oh, that's funny. Okay, so anyways, we need to get... Oh, God, I'm so freaking flustered. Okay, so we need to get the Quetzal. We need to go out and get that female Therizinosaurus because, holy Jesus, that's a 145 female Therizinosaurus. And, guys, we have 150 male. We have a 150 male, and then we have a 145 male. And when we can breed that thing with the 150 male, the stats that thing is going to have is going to be crazy. All right, let's see. Let's go ahead and grab Pretzel. Jump on Pretzel and we'll fly over there. Oh yeah, I forgot. Pretzel's a little bit slow. So one thing that I might start doing on Pretzel to kind of match speeds with Mother Goose is I'm probably going to start pumping a little bit of movement speed into Pretzel. Now she's got, let's see. Is this a he? Are you a boy or a girl? What are you? This is a male. Okay, I couldn't remember which one was the male and female. So he's got mostly health and melee damage pumped into him. In fact, that's the only levels that I've actually pumped into Pretzel the Quetzal. So if I get any more levels, which it's only gonna be a few more levels because I'm at 150,000 XP. That's level 20. Then I'll probably just pump movement speed instead of melee damage again. Let's see, is that the 145? That's the 25. Where's the 145? I know I saw 145. You saw it too. There's video evidence. That's not the one. Oh, there it is. Okay, good. I was like, that's not the 145. Okay. Good, good, good. Okay, we got the Therizinosaurus. Perfect. Okay, she's gonna do a little bit of damage to me. Hopefully she doesn't knock me out. I keep forgetting that these things do a little bit of torpor damage every time they hit, but it won't send my torpor up anywhere. Like, it goes up a little bit and then it comes all the way back down. So, it was actually probably a good idea that I grabbed Pretzel because she's got, like, almost 60k health. So, these hits are not even going to bother me. That's doing 37 damage per hit. That's pretty good, actually. I'm not gonna lie. That's pretty damn good. So, I know, Therizinosauruses can damage stone, but she shouldn't be able to break through this entire, enclosure by the time I tame her. So, let's see. We'll go ahead and drop her inside of there. And she is in there. She is trapped, and we are good to go. Oh my god. This is going to be awesome, guys. This is going to be so freaking cool. What a way to start out the episode, right? 145 female Therizinosaurus right off the bat. Hot diggity damn. All right, we'll go ahead and grab almost 100 Chalking Tranks, and we'll be good to go on that front. So let's see. Let's come out here and see if she can reach me. Outside the cage, and if she can, I'll just stand about a foot and a half away from her, and then we'll be good. Alright, Therizinosaurus, you ready to get knocked out, sweetheart? How you doing, big girl? Yes! Oh, I'm so freaking excited. Oh my god. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and get this bad girl all tranked up, and as soon as she's knocked out and we're ready to tame her, guys, I'll bring you guys right back in. Alright, you guys. Just in one more bite or two more bites, maybe. It might actually take two more bites. The goatee monster will be ours. So, I actually had a... Oh, I'm so damn happy we got this thing. Let's check its stats out. So, we're sitting at 6,090.6 health, 2,100 stam, 780 oxygen, 19,650 food, 726.4 weight, 339.1 melee, and 100% movement speed, guys. Holy crap. We got her. We got the female pair to both of our males, and now we can start pooping out Therizinosaurus babies, and they're gonna be high freaking level babies, guys. Holy Jesus. This is gonna be awesome. Alright, so what I was saying before I tamed her up was, while I was taming her and while she was like unconscious and stuff like that, and am I stuck inside of her tails? Okay, there we go. There was a scorpion. But it was the weirdest thing. The scorpion didn't attack me. It walked right up to me, but it didn't attack me. I mean, I obviously Shrek'd its face, but I was like, it scared the hell out of me. But it didn't attack me for some reason, so I don't exactly know what's going on with that. But anyways, guys, we got a brand new Therizinosaurus. Let's go ahead and put her on passive, and we're going to need a name for this one too, guys. So we got Freddy Krueger, we got Tickle Fingers, and now we're going to need another name for our brand new female Therizinosaurus, guys. So let me know down in the comments if you guys have any cool names, and I'd love to hear from you guys. So now we can get on with some more stuff in today's episode, guys. So the Troodon and the Perlovia are pretty much the only dinos besides the Basilosaurus that I have not tamed yet in Ark. Now, the Perlovia is what I'm going to want right now. However, the Troodon, it has a strange way to tame it. I was reading up on the wiki and stuff like that, and the only way that you tame a Troodon is with a baby dino sacrifice? Like, what the crap? How sadistic are the Ark devs to make a taming method? The only way to tame a dino is to sacrifice one of your other baby dinos to it to appease it. Almost like it's a freaking, jealous god or something like that. It's crazy. But All I know is I want a couple of them. I want a couple Troodons, like high-level Troodons, guys. Let's go ahead and check on Tickle Tentacles and Sunset. Make sure they're all there, still alive. Yep, I see the tentacle. Wonderful. So I want a couple Troodons that are high level. I'm talking 140s and up, and I want a male and female so that when I have both of them, I can breed a Troodon army. Because if you've watched me before and if you've followed me on YouTube and stuff like that in some of my other ARC series, I had a Dimorphodon army, and that thing would shred through shit like it was like butter on toast. I'm not even kidding. Like, that thing, the army of Dimorphodons was insane. I think I had upwards of, like, 40 Dimorphodons, and those things would just demolish anything. In fact, we took them up against a Giga, and it got the Giga enraged. And that's a lot of damage to deal only with Dimorphodons. But anyways, I want to kind of have the same thing with Troodons, except instead of going up against, like, Gigas and stuff like that, I just want them for protection and stuff like that. Just load them up on the back of a Quetzal or something like that, and then just go around and either level them up that way or just let them level passively. But, you know, I want a couple Troodons. And another dino that I had forgotten that we don't have is the Pegomastax, that piece of crap that steals my frickin' canteen every single time it looks at me. I would kind of like to get one of those, too, just to see what it's like, you know, because I want to get every dino from the update. And speaking of update, guys, I'm filming this at around 12:16, 12:20 on the day before the update came out. So if the update video is not posted on Thursday, it'll probably come out this Friday. So just keep your eyes open for it, and I can't wait for that new update. Like, it's going to be crazy fun. The tech structures are going to come out, and we'll be able to do that as soon as we get into the tech tier and stuff like that. And it's just going to be a lot of fun, guys. So let's see. I really wish that Pretzel could run or sprint just a tad bit faster. That would be kind of nice, but the Perlovia that we found was up kind of closer towards the back of the Redwood Forest, so that's probably going to be the place where I start looking. Unfortunately, it's still early dawn, and it is a little bit dark inside of the Redwood Forest because of all the gigantic freaking trees, but I'm sure we can find one. So, hopefully, the one that we do find will be high level, guys, and then we can just kind of have a good old time taming a Perlovia. We're gonna fly it back to the base and tame it there as long as I can. I've been told that the Perlovia does some sort of stun attack similar to the Baryonyx. So if it does that while I'm flying, then we're gonna be kind of screwed. But I guess we'll cross that bridge when we get there. So I'm gonna do a little bit of looking around for a Perlovia, guys, and then I'll bring you guys back in. All right, you guys. There's a Perlovia in the area. There he is. I see him. I see him. I see him. Gimme! 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 I want him. I picked up an ant? Really? I didn't even think you could even pick up ants. Where the hell did that Perlovia go? Oh, it's right there. I see it. I see it. I see it. Get into my clutches, big guy. Come here. Wait, can you even pick these things up? I could have sworn I hit him. Okay, let's see. Let's swoop around one more time. That's a terror bird. Well, I don't need him. Let's go ahead and drop him over here. Where's the Perlovia at? He's right there. Let me swoop in and pick him up. See if I can. Yes, I got him. Perfect. I got the Perlovia. Okay, what level is this bad boy? I didn't even check it. I just saw it. 45. Okay. You know what? I will take a level 45 Perlovia. I'm not going for the highest level Perlovia. I just want a damn Perlovia because I think it's going to be super freaking cool. So, I love his color, too. He looks like a raccoon. Look at that. That's so cool. He's got like black and brown stripes and white stripes and stuff like that. That's super cool. Okay, so I'm going to fly him back to the taming pen, get him all tamed up, and then I'll bring you guys back in. And there he is, you guys. Oh man, level 67 Perlovia. So like I said, not the most hefty dino, not the most like useful. You can't even ride the damn thing as far as I'm concerned, but it is super cool. So guess what, guys? We're gonna need a name for this guy too, and that's gonna be pretty cool. He does kind of look like a raccoon. Let's get a better look at him. I don't know why I was just tripping over my own words. It's like I tripped over my own tongue. All right, let's see. Oh, he looks so freaking cool. Look at him. Look at those teeth. Oh my god, those are sharp. Okay, and then I guess we just hit what? Let's go ahead and put him on passive before I forget. Let's go ahead and bury him. Look at that. Oh my god, that's a freaking rock. That's a damn rock. You would not be able to see that without names. Look at how well hidden that is. Oh my god. That is cool. All right, let's go ahead and put some of this meat on him. I know I've got a trough up, but that's okay. So let's see. I don't even know what to pump on this guy. I would assume weight, because I want to start storing things inside of him and then bury him underground and make an invincible freaking storage container. That'd be pretty cool. All right, so let's see. Let's pull him over here by the herbivores and stuff like that. Even though he's not an herbivore, we'll just put him over here and then we'll bury him. That's so dang cool. I love the fact that you can just bury him. And like with the new Thylacio that's coming out, you can jump from freaking tree to tree. That's so crazy. All right, big guy, go ahead and go under the ground. That's so cool. Oh, I love that so much. Okay, so now comes the freaking hard part, guys. Now comes the part where I'm thinking I'm going to have to build something in order to do it. So I want to try my luck at taming a Troodon, and the only way we're going to do that is with a few Rex Eggs. But guess what I've got on extra right here? Look at all the Rex Eggs. Oh, baby. So the reason I had all these eggs is mainly because back when I was breeding Titan and the 145 female, I just forgot to stop them breeding or make them stop breeding. So I have a whole bunch of garbage eggs worth of Rexes that I need to get pooped out. So maybe a way that I could do this is hatch the T-Rexes out. Well, I could hatch the T-Rexes inside of here, build a kind of like a pen, fly out, find a Troodon, and then incubate the eggs. Yeah, I can definitely do that. So I'll build a little bit of a pen, incubate the T-Rex eggs, and then build a fence around it, and then put the Troodons inside of it, or something like that. I actually don't even know how it works. I think it's just kind of a proximity thing to the Troodons and to the babies. So let me go ahead and, let's see, maybe we should do this over at the, yeah, we should probably do this over at the breeding place. So let me go ahead and fly over to the breeding place, guys, and get construction done on this, like, sacrifice pen. It sounds so freaking terrible. And then we're gonna see if we can't tame some Troodons, guys. So I'll see you soon. Alrighty, so back at the breeding pen, I've got kind of a pen set up and kind of a system that I think might work. It involves foundations and railings, and once we get back with some Troodons, then I can absolutely show that to you. But it's funny, I never thought, within the amount of time that I've been playing on Ark and stuff like that, and I've had this update with the Troodons and the Tussotuthis and the Basilosaurus and all that stuff, I never actually thought that I would be deliberately trying to find something that is probably considered one of the most terrifying dinosaurs on the island, and the thing is the size of my chest. Literally, it's the size of my damn chest. In fact, it's nothing to be afraid of until it comes at you in swarms of 15,000 freaking Troodons. So I just think it's kind of funny that I've never actually deliberately looked for these things, but now that I'm doing it, it's kind of nerve-wracking, because I know as soon as one of those suckers sees me, I've got five more to worry about that are hiding in the bushes somewhere waiting to kill me. You know, that's another thing we should probably get is a beaver. We don't have a beaver yet. Granted, we have the Therizinosaurus, but the beaver is a mobile smithy, and that's what I want him for. So I'm out in the forests at a Moss Chops. We don't have one of those yet. I'm out in the forests looking for these damn Troodons, and I haven't found one. Like, normally I would at least have stumbled upon at least one of them and then run away quite fast, but I can't seem to find where they're at. Like, I know they spawn in the woods and stuff like that, and I think the redwoods is one of their main spawns, but the fact that redwoods are so damn far, oh god, away from the mainland, that's what deters me from going all the way over there and flying all the way back with a little Troodon in my clutches. God, the Therizinosaurus spawns are real. There are so many through here. That's crazy. There are so many back here. I should have come over here when I was looking for the 145 or the 150. Hot damn. Okay, so I'm going to continue to try and look for one of these Troodons. I could have sworn I would have, like, come across one already. It's kind of mind-boggling that I haven't... Oh, wait. Yes, those are Troodons. Yes. Okay, no, one of them hit me. That sucks. Okay, let's see. What level are you, big guys? What level are these Troodons, huh? I can't even see them. Oh, hello, Therizinosaurus. Oh, that's high level. Oh, no, it's not. That's only a level 15. That's kind of funny. Okay, is it fighting the Troodons? Okay, we need to pick one of those guys up. What level is... That's a level 60. Let's go ahead and kill this level 60. Where's the other one at? It was fighting that Therizinosaurus. What the crap? Did he just fall out of my clutches or something? Or is he still in there? Nope, he's gone. That little guy is free to roam again. Okay, let's see. Where is that other Troodon at? Oh my god, there's so much shit coming after me. That's a level 50 Dilophosaurus. Okay, I think I saw like a major freaking swarm of Troodons. And they're all standing, like, right there. Let's see. That's a level 60. That was the one that I was killing. They like to... It looks like they like to swarm around the feet. Oh, wait. What level was that? Was that a level 150? No, that was only level 20. Damn. So it looks like the highest level one over here is, like, a level 60. And that's kind of unfortunate. The fact that only level 60 would spawn. I know I've been killed by something much higher than a level 60 Trudon. Let's see. What level is that one? I can't see through my bird. Well, that's unfortunate. Let's see. Let's go ahead and fly straight up and, nope, I don't see any more. Let's see. Where? Okay, that Carno is really starting to annoy me. Oh, God. No. No. Bad. Okay, good. Good, good, good. Let's see. There's that Trudon right there. What level is it? 50. That says 50, right? Not 150. Okay, I'm gonna hold on to this guy because I damaged that, that level 60 pretty bad. But you know what? Actually, wait. Were there more Trudons, or was that this one making a fuss? I think that was this one making a little bit of a fussy noise. Poor little guy. Okay, so let's go ahead and try out this method back at the breeding area. And if it works, then I will have a Trudon, and then I can go out and get more with this method. So let me go ahead and fly back to the breeding area, guys. Okay, you guys, so we got a level 249 T-Rex. Let's go ahead and put some meat on it just in case, and we're going to see if this method works. So let's go ahead and grab some of this meat, and then we'll be good to go. Alrighty then. Alright, so let's go ahead and put this inside of you. I'm going to go ahead and take off wandering on you so that you don't go anywhere. Disable neutral onto passive, and then we need you to follow right next to me, big guy. Alright, come this way, big guy. I'm sorry I'm going to have to do this to you, but it's going to happen. It's going to happen. Why did you swing it so damn wide? You got stuck in the AC unit, didn't you? No, you didn't. Okay, good. Good, good, good. All right, now come this way, big guy. No, don't swing it wide again. These damn T-Rexes, man. It's like swinging around a freaking Mack truck. All right, come here, big guy. There we go. Hello there, Mr. Trudon. Would you like a sacrifice? Look at him in there. He's just chilling. Look at his little butt. All right, come here, big guy. Come on. Come on, little guy. Okay, this is going to be a little bit sad if this happens. Okay, let's see what happens with the baby Rex being on the pedestal right here. Now, what's going to happen? Do they have to be in the same, like, vicinity, or am I taming it already? It's just I can't see it. Can I see you, big guy? Let's see. Maybe if I do this, we'll go ahead and block him in just like this. Just like that. And then, how the hell am I going to do this? Let's see. Let's go ahead and block him in just like this. Oh, this is so sad. Holy shit, this is sad. Okay, and then, how the hell am I gonna, let's see, what if I do it like this? Actually, no, here, let's do it this way. I need you to click the, there we go, there it was. I saw it, I just saw it! Go, now! 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 I can't hit the button fast enough. Okay, fine, be that way. So I don't exactly know how I'm going to do this. Perhaps, maybe, patience? Let's see. What about this one? Is this the right one? It was the right one. Okay. Can you get to the baby now, big guy? Let's see. If I can do that on that one, I can do it on this lower one, too. Let's see. Stone railing. Perfect. Okay, there you go. Now you have a complete and utter, like, track to the baby T-Rex. Get in there, big guy. Feast, little guy. Okay, I have zero clue what's going on. Like, I'm not even kidding. I have no idea how to tame this thing. I don't see any bar on him besides the maturation one. It's a baby. Maybe if I walk away from it. Maybe it's aggroed on me. Let's watch it from back here. Okay, Trudon. Female Trudon. Does it have to be unclaimed? Let's try that. Let's see. Let's go and unclaim this baby T-Rex. There we go. Now what, Trudon? Do you want this baby Rex? Can you not even eat this baby Rex? Is it too big for you, big guy, huh? Is it too big for you? What's going on? You got kind of a cute face once you're not trying to kill me. Interesting. Okay, so I don't exactly know what's going on with this, guys. I assume it's still aggroed on me. But even then, it should go out... What the crap? Oh, something was hitting the spikes. It should go after the T-Rex, should it not? Wait. Interesting. Very interesting. Okay, so, That's kind of unfortunate. I don't know how you're supposed to get these bad boys, because I know it's a sacrifice. It's they get affinity or something like that from killing babies, and that's terrible, but they get it from killing babies. I know that for a fact. So will you, like... Can I punch you? No, I can't. Okay. Get in there with the baby Rex. Come on. Eat the baby Rex. God dang it. Okay, so interesting. I'm gonna go ahead and claim it again, see what happens. Yes, he's standing right by the T-Rex. That's so interesting. I have no idea how to do this, guys. So I tell you what, I think I'm going to do a little bit of research over that, or on the Troodon, off camera and stuff like that. But I think I'm going to actually go ahead and end off today's episode right here, because we are all out of time. So amidst all the Rex butts, I hope you guys enjoyed today's episode, because we got a freaking 145 Therizinosaurus female, and we got a level 40, actually it's a level 67 Perlovia that all need names, guys. And then hopefully, with a little bit of research and stuff like that, we can find out how to tame these Troodons. I'm gonna just leave him in there. This Rex will probably end up dying anyways, so we'll be good to go on that front, guys. But I hope you guys enjoyed today's episode, and if you did, make sure you smash that like button, subscribe for more daily videos. And if you haven't done already, follow me on Twitter, excuse me, at CouchPotato1898. And I will see you guys in the next video.